بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. There's been a video that's circling around there. A certain Ostaza, African American sister, giving a talk in a conference, talking about the Me Too movement and the issues surrounding, women being abused, especially our daughters, and how there's silence and people are not supposed to talk. And she makes a lot of good points. I just wanted to make a few corrections because it might be misunderstood. And she seems to be a supporter of the Me Too movement, which I'm gonna address in a second. But her main point is like, how come the brothers, the Muslim brothers, where are they? Why were they not supporting this Me Too movement? Then she talks about the issue of education and how women have to be educated, okay, which we agree, but we're gonna address in a second, what kind of education. And then she talks about the issue of رجال قوامون على النساء, which I'm gonna start with in the first place, because we have to make sure that we get the right terminology and the right things. She goes into the root words of قَوَّمُونَ, رِجَالُ قَوَّمُونَ عَلَى النِّسَاءِ. She says, if I say to you قَوْم, what do you say? You should stand up. Okay, it's a mistake. It's قُوم, not قَوْم. قَوْم means people. What happens is when people get into interpretations like that to make a point, it can lead to the wrong understanding. So, for example, the Parvesis and Quraniyas, they talked about the meaning of Salah, and they went into, you look in the dictionary, Salah, what does it mean? It means du'a. Okay, because in Lugha, Salah means dua actually, but istilahi in the Sharia, it means the 5-day prayers. Just a small example of how a group of people have went astray. Because a lot of times, if I believe the pervasives, they don't pray because they say it's just dua, it's not Salah. These 5 daily prayers is an invention. And I'm just giving an example how if you're not careful with the root words and try to get into dictionary meetings and you don't have not studied the Sharia, it's very easy to go astray and to lead others astray. I'm not saying the sister is, but it's a mistake that we have to correct. Number two, I believe that yes, men should stand up for women. And that is what Islam preaches, actually. We don't need a Me Too movement. We don't need the West to tell us how to treat our women, okay? The solution that I always say, guys, it's going back to Islam. I mean, to have real men, real rijal, you know, the real Omars and the real Khalids and the real Hamzas and the real Alis and the real Abu Bakrs. This is where it is. But our men right now are confused. So hence, they don't treat women properly. But some of the Imams and the preachers now are trying to interpret different ayat of the Quran to fit in with the Western agenda. And hence, still after 10 or 15 years of doing that, it still hasn't solved the problems of abuse of females and of rape and all these things. It still hasn't, because it shows you that that's not how you do it. You do it by going back to Islam. The sister gets a bit angry at the fact that the brothers are not supporting the Me Too movement. She looked around. She was at the big march against Donald Trump. She didn't see the brothers. Where are the brothers? Look, with all due respect, okay, big march, big noise and whatnot. Donald Trump is still sitting in his nice seat in the White House laughing at you guys. Because they can't do anything, couldn't impeach him, they couldn't do anything. Because the solution to your problems is not that type of march, it's not that type of movement, with all due respect, supported by so many women. Yes, there's a big problem with that. I'm not saying that these women have not been abused. The solution, guys, is Islam. It's Islam. So instead of having a Me Too hash, it should be a, I accept Islam hashtag. But people don't understand. We are targeting the wrong things with the wrong tools. You know, it's not about dumbing down males. It's not about, having less, manly men. And, no, that's not how you protect women, okay, from abuse, from any of these issues through Islam. Like, just clear thing. Just one example, guys. Okay, what happens? In Islam, if someone abuses a woman, if someone dares to lay their hands on your daughter, which of course is the man, as a man I would, but Islam, does not allow me to just take matters into my own hand, it will deal with it, okay? And men should never, as fathers, be quiet if someone touches their daughter or their wife or anything like that. This is an aman on you. Allah will punish you for this. You gotta remember that. That's number one. Okay, but Islam solved the problem. Do you know what it means to abuse a woman or to have any kind of sexual abuse? It is basically death. Do you understand? It is in the Sharia, the had, or the punishment for anyone raping or abuse. In the worst case, rape, of course, is death. But abuse will get ta'zir, punishment will be, I mean, very bad punishment, right? And it's public, and it's to deter other people. Right now, what happens? You go to court, look at Donald Trump. What happened? Nothing. Nothing happens. So what happens is it gives these criminals the courage that, hey, we can do it. It's no problem. I can do this as much as I want to, because no one is going to do anything to me. But in Islam, no. That's what I say, guys. Even in my Muslim Alpha Man course, I teach men to be, gentlemen, to be righteous. But the solution is to be like Omar, to be like Khalid, to be like Ali, to be like Hamza, not to be not like them, not to try to be Western, not to, you know, to go to an education system that is actually dumbing down and destroying our men. And then they're confused. Of course, they don't know what to do. Of course, they're not going to act properly. Of course, they're going to start doing all kinds of things. And the men will start losing, women will start losing their mind and going to a different direction. And it's a reactionary type of behavior, because that's what's happening with these kind of marches, and our sisters joining these kind of marches because they had enough. They don't have the real men to protect them, so now they start doing all kinds of stuff, right? So it's not the correct thing to do. We need to return back to Islam. We need to have more men, more males who are strong and tough, and they implement Islam properly, and they follow the Sharia correctly. This is the solution, guys. This is the solution, not the Me Too movement and I don't know what and this and that. No, the solution is Islam. The solution is knowledge, education. What kind of education? The Prophet ﷺ used to seek refuge from non-beneficial knowledge. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min ilma la yanfa. Right? So we're shoving our kids in this educational system that is dumbing them down, is confusing them. The boys are becoming girls, the girls are becoming boys, they're crossing over, they're doing all kinds of stuff, and then we're wondering why we're having problems. And our Muslim sisters, instead of preaching to people they should come back to Islam, instead of supporting and saying men, and I think the sister has good knee, alhamdulillah, and she's saying that she has her child with her and she's not a feminist, but I think she's using the wrong approach to solve the problem. The solution is not a march, it's not Me Too movement, it's not, when amongst this Me Too movement there's a lot of controversy, is about Islam, coming back to Islam. The men, teaching your son that you have to be a real man, and having the examples, pointing the hand, hey, Khalid was the real one, Abdullah ibn Mubarak was the real one, Hamza radiallahu anhu, Ali radiallahu anhu, Uthman, Abu Bakr, Umar, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But we don't know what kind of education. We have no clue who these people are. And because we are being bombarded with all kinds of propaganda, when we read their lives, we start saying like, this is not so altruistic, it's not so empathetic the way they behave, maybe because it's in their time in the desert. No, there's no such thing. There's no argument in terms of time. It was forever. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنٌ. Okay? The Prophet ﷺ is the best example. The Sahaba are the best example. Were they perfect? I mean, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one who's perfect. But they were the best prototypes, the best models for us to be like, okay, in this life. And we have to teach our boys, our men, to avoid the solution to stopping, you know, beating women and abuse to women and rape and sexual, you know, harassment, all this, is not marches and Me Too movements. It is Islam, coming back to the deen, fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, implementing the Sharia. This is it. It'll protect. Imagine if someone touches your daughter, or someone rapes, a'udhu billah, your wife or something like that, and then people tell them, shh, don't tell, it's a shame for the family. A lot of people, they do that. Why? Because it's this whole shame thing. But the Prophet was very clear as to how the people get punished. And he punished them, and he punished them in public. But because the Muslims have been brainwashed through colonization, through culture, they've separated Islam from the culture, make them feel ashamed in Islam, but make them feel proud in the culture. Of course, they say, no, it's in our culture. We have to be careful. We have to keep quiet. Yeah, this is the problem. The problem is that people are putting their culture above Islam. And even in the West, this is the issue with such speeches, that people are putting the Western culture above Islam. Let's return back to Islam. Let's be real men. We have to strengthen and to teach and to develop and to give tarbiyah to real men, to make these boys into real men and real women.